The 17 News at Noon podcast is brought to you by Clinica Sierra Vista.
Welcome back to the 17 News at Noon podcast, where we share your news on your schedule.
Well, good day. I'm Elena Ruska alongside Chief Forecaster Kevin Shroud. Of course, our top story once again, this record-shattering heat. Yikes. But a bit of good news from yesterday's record-breaking heat. State power officials are saying peak demand for electricity hit a new all-time record in the afternoon, but there were no rolling blackouts thanks to customers' conservation efforts. Yesterday, a Phase 3 energy emergency alert was announced. That's one step below ordering the rotating blackouts. That was in addition to a flex alert that was already in place. Emergency alerts were sent to Californian phones, and the ISO tweeted last night, consumer conservation played a big part in protecting electric grid reliability. Now, unfortunately for today, another flex alert has already been issued, asking us all to conserve yet again, especially between those busy hot hours of 4 to 9 p.m. And just minutes ago, the California ISO declaring an energy emergency alert level 1, warning that rotating power outages may come again today, the threat of them at least, if conservation measures are not taken.
And a reminder that it's not just the intense heat, but our air quality is unhealthy as well. The Get Bus program is offering free rides again today due to bad air quality, which is unhealthy for sensitive groups. Whenever the air quality index is over 150, it's considered unhealthy. And today's forecast is 161 for the valley. To check air quality, download the San Joaquin Air Pollution Control District app for free on the app. And it's also free on Google Play.
Yeah, it is. All right, so now to the wildfires happening across California. We're just hearing a new one of the mosquito fire outside of Sacramento, so that's coming in now. But here we've been watching the Route Fire on I-5 continuing to be a major problem for drivers heading north from the LA area.
Yeah, two northbound lanes of the 5 will remain closed as Caltrans assesses damage to the retaining walls caused by the Route Fire. The closed lanes of the freeway extend from about 3 miles starting near Parker Road up to around Vista del Largo Road near Pyramid Lake. Caltrans is advising drivers to take the 101 freeway or State Route 14 as an alternate route over the next couple of days. The Route Fire has charred more than 5,200 acres and is now 98% contained.
All right, thank you, Kevin. Now to our follow-up file. A second victim has died following a suspected DUI rollover crash on the 5 near Lubeck. About 40 minutes ago, the Kern County coroner confirming 18-year-old Erica Hayden died at Kern Medical on August 31st, 4 days after that crash. 20-year-old Tony Ray Charles was also killed at the scene of that crash on August 27th. Investigators say the driver, 18-year-old Delia Johnson, was also hurt. She was taken to Kern Medical for treatment, but has not yet been charged in this case. Now to your 17 Court Watch. The man charged in the death of corrections counselor Benny Alcala Jr. was removed from court this morning after repeatedly swearing loudly and referring to the murder charge he's facing. After several warnings, a deputy removed Robert Purnell Roberts from the courtroom. This morning's hearing, which involves him allegedly violating probation, will now take place at 3 p.m. this afternoon during Roberts' formal arraignment on charges of the murder of Benny Alcala Jr. According to court documents, a witness reported Roberts targeted Alcala because he was charging an electric vehicle and he figured he must have money. Alcala died at the scene of the shooting the night of August 24th outside the Target on Stockdale Highway. We will be back in court this afternoon for that hearing with the latest on this case coming up on 17 News at 5.
Hello, this is Tim Callahan with Clinica Sierra Vista, and we're excited to unveil the Community Health Center of the Future, our comprehensive care center. It's located right across the street from Memorial Hospital. We have every service under one roof, from family medicine, OBGYN care, dental services for adults and children, behavioral health, and much more. So find your way to better care at Clinica Sierra Vista this year at our comprehensive care center. Visit our website, clinicasierravista.org, for the latest on this project. We'll see you soon.
News, your local election headquarters. A series of community education workshops continuing as county officials engage the public on a proposed 1 cent sales tax increase. It will appear as Measure K on your November election ballot if you live in unincorporated Kern areas. The local control tax measure is one way to offset revenue losses to the county as property taxes from the oil and gas industry continue to decline. Recent surveys of voters in unincorporated Kern show strong support for maintaining and improving vital public safety-related services like emergency response, crime prevention, and homelessness. Two public education workshops are slated for this week. The first one tonight from 6 to 7 in Pine Mountain Club in the Condor Room. And tomorrow night, September 8th, a workshop will be held in Bear Valley Springs from 6 to 7 at the Whiting Center. The public is encouraged to attend. Now some education news this morning. Bakersfield College hosted a ribbon cutting for the grand opening of their new science and engineering building. It comes complete with a robotics laboratory for the industrial automation students. The three-story, 71,000 square foot building also has chemistry and biology labs, physics and engineering classes. District officials say this building is now complete thanks to the funding from Measure J, a $502 million bond passed back in 2016.
This building here is the crown jewel of Measure J for Bakersfield College. This is where our students can learn today for the jobs of tomorrow.
Now, this is the second ground-up building at BC to come from Measure J. The first was their student leadership building. Well, the Kern Dance Alliance has been awarded more than $4.2 million by the California Arts Council to administer the California Creative Core program throughout the Central Valley. This pilot program is designed to use the arts to promote community and civic engagement, spread awareness about water and energy conservation, climate change, emergency preparedness, relief, and recovery. The KDA says they will create a project called the KDA Creative Core, which will turn around and re-grant these funds to arts and social service organizations, individual artists, and cultural workers across our region. This money won't fund the KDA's existing programs, however, which organizers say will still need continued community support for daily operation. And the One Book Project is back for the fall, inviting Kern County to read along and discuss the themes of their pick, A Mighty Long Way, My Journey to Justice at Little Rock High School by Carlotta Walls Lanier. Every year, the Kern County Library and CSUB team up for the One Book Project, bringing community members together through events related to the title they've chosen. This book explores civil rights, racial discrimination, racism, diversity, and more. Readers can sign up for the One Book Project on the Beanstack app, or you can head over to their website, kclonebook.org.
The 17 News at Noon podcast is a production of KGET and Nexstar Media Group. For more on all of the headlines in today's show, head to kget.com.